The red light appearing. Ready. The second for the day. They stand well. Racing. Good line out. Desiné probably a half a step behind them when he let them go. Pompeii was the first to jump, and Beccolotti will have to sit outside of it early on, but they're going to beat off Beach West, so they're going quite quickly in the early stages of proceedings. Over on the outside, Desiné goes up just a shade, Finchie, and they've followed further back by Amber Glide, settling about four lengths from the leader, dropping out the back at the tail, the newcomer Kisses for Kelly. They leave the back on the far corner by the 900. Pompeii pilots the field. Beccolotti's up at its girth, running second, the speed slowing. Beach West over on the inside occupies third spot, being shaded by Desiné and the Pink Silks. A length and a half, Amber Glide, who travels up well on the outside of Finchie, and back there at the tail end of the field is Kisses from Kelly. Inside the 600 they head towards the turn, and Beccolotti goes up now to test Pompeii. So they share the lead, Pompeii, Beccolotti, who's travelling well for McNaught behind those, then Desiné following their move into the home straight. On the rails then is Beach West, and Amber Glide heads the others with Finchie. At the 350, Pompeii with a kick on the inside of Beccolotti, a length and a half, Amber Glide winding up outside of Desiné. Inside the 175, Beccolotti, Amber Glide on the outside trying to cut the margin down. Amber Glide goes up, grabs Beccolotti. Amber Glide is too good. Amber Glide goes home to beat Beccolotti. Third, Pompeii just in front of Desiné, I fancy. Then Finchie, followed further back by Beach West, and with it towards the tail is Kisses from Kelly. Number 8, Amber Glide's the winner, ridden by Joe Azzopardi. Amber Glide, number 8. Gee, it's got out to be at a very good price as well, this filly, by Nakoni. She's jumped 11 with the SP. Amber Glide, prepared by Ross Price. First time here at Belmont Park, appreciating the bigger, open, longer home straight, and certainly the step into a 1400, and she has proven too good. Taking out race number 2 this afternoon, getting home over the top of Beccolotti, which had to do the bullock work outside of Pompeii, and it kicked. Desiné was close up, but all honours with Amber Glide. Raced by Frank and Josie Fiore. She's a Nakoni filly out of Royal Devotion, prepared by Ross Price in our southwest, and ridden by Joe Azzopardi. Made sure that he was following one of the impressive last start winners in the race, Desiné, to the turn, and certainly the scope of this filly stretching to the 1400 was right there in her favour. Too good in race number 2 on the card. Beccolotti by A-Lot from As If Becknick, trained by Tiana Robertson. Ridden by Jade McNaught, as we stand by for the full list of the numbers to come through. Pompeii kicked on the inside. William Pike for Team Williams. It's 8, 10 and 5. Pompeii, third, just in front of Desiné. 8, 10, 5 and 3. And a length, a short neck, the margins. The time is 1:24.14. And the split 34.75. 34 and 3 quarters there. The last 600 there, but on this pedigree, the further she goes out over a bit more ground and with maturity and time, she's certainly going to pick off a few more wins as well in the ensuing future. Amber Glide, the way that she won here this afternoon over Beccolotti and Pompeii. Pompeii's by Extravagant from Gotta Be You, and Desiné was fourth in. The third, the Amelia Park Maiden over 1200, 8 Quillo out with 13 Birthday Ballot in this next event. And let's go downstairs now, and we'll catch up with Brittany joining us after the running of race number 2. Amber Glide, she got out at a crazy old price for a filly of her potential.
Yeah, she did. Double figures for Amber Glide. Just start number 3 today. Ross Price joins me, and up to 1,400 metres and a long Belmont straight. You must have been pretty happy with this assignment for her.
Absolutely, and the way the race looked before the race, it looked it might pan out. There was two or three that were going to go quick. And she seemed to be winding up in her races at the finish. So I thought, you know, this is a race that's going to really suit her today.
Obviously know the family. We've spoken about her before. Of what you saw today at 1400 running through the line, how far do you think she does get in the future?
Look, I think she's probably a mile. She's a mile horse, but, I mean, she got away better today. I mean, look, I wouldn't say further than that, but, I mean, she may well do. Being by Nakoni, you wouldn't expect her to go too much further. But, I mean, she did that really well today. And Yeah, I'm very pleased with her.
Just start number three of her career and this preparation. What's next for her?
We'll just find out how she pulls up. May give her one more, but won't give her a lot more before she has a bit of a break. But no, she's doing really well.
She's done her job this campaign, that is for sure, and certain. Hopefully we see her one more. Well done on the win here of Amber Glyde.
Thank you very much.
There is Ross Price. Let's get over to Joey Azzopardi.
Well, Joey, I suppose in a map sense that worked out perfectly. You were following Clint, one of the horses to beat into the race, and got a lovely toe into it.
Yeah, it did. It looked like it was going to play out that way on paper too. There was good speed in the race, and my feeling she gets back a bit, so the pattern of the race really suited.
And step out in distance today, certainly in her favour as well.
Yeah, definitely. She's definitely progressed a lot with each run too. She was pretty immature at the start of the prep, and she's really developing into a nice horse.
And barrier number one last start at Ascot, probably not the best, most suitable draw for her.
No, definitely not. Like I said, she still does a bit wrong, so she needs a little bit of time to wind up and to get balanced, and drawing a bit wider today was much more suitable.
Blazing away goes the Pinjarra Cup on the weekend. Excited to be aboard him again?
Yeah, definitely. He was 3 weeks before his 3 weeks between runs before his last win, so Dave opted to go that way again, and he'll be a great chance.
Congratulations, well done, mate.
Thank you, cheers.
There is Joey Azzopardi, and it is Amber Glyde who takes out the second for Ross Price.